SignComp introduces the most advanced flexible sign fabric tensioning system on the market. The SignComp tensioning system. The SignComp tensioning system permits flexible sign faces of all sizes to be easily tensioned into the highly efficient SignComp extruded aluminum frames. SignComp tension clips are attached to the flexible sign fabric graphic side up, so you can avoid damaging pre-decorated faces. Once the tension clips are snapped in place, the flexible sign fabric can be easily installed in the SignComp frame in minutes. The unique locking mechanism prevents the tension clips from working loose or falling off, so the flexible sign fabric can be easily rolled for transport to the job site or put aside for use later. Loss of tension will not occur with the SignComp tensioning system. The flexible sign fabric is gripped tightly, and the system is engineered to actually increase the grip as the wind pushes and pulls the sign face. Let's look at the components of the SignComp tensioning system. There are a variety of designs to allow for both framed and frameless flexible sign fabric applications. Hingeable cabinets and retainers, retro frames, frame brace and frame support tube assemblies for compression reinforcement, as well as fascia band systems. A unique divider system that separates flexible sign panels or integrates rigid face materials with the flexible sign fabric in one extruded frame. And cast aluminum radius corners. This is the dual frame extrusion, which accommodates both flexible sign fabric and rigid sign faces. All SignComp frames have an extruded frame cover and a tension channel with inward-facing stair-step teeth. This 3/4-inch or 2 cm tension channel offers a great deal of tensioning adjustment in both directions by allowing up to 1.5-inch or 4 cm of tensioning across the sign face. The tension clips, which slide into the tension channel, are injection-molded Delrin plastic, made up of two parts, a flat mandrel with 3 locking voids on the underside, and the clip body. The clip body has several teeth that mate with the teeth in the tension channel of the extruded frames. Note that teeth are only on one side of the clip, and teeth are only on one side of the tension channel. The fabric is wrapped around the mandrel and trapped within the tension clip body. The result is similar to that of a sailor's knot. The more you pull, the tighter the grip. When the teeth of the tension clip are engaged with the teeth of the tension channel, the clip cannot release from the extruded frame. Applying tension to the fabric forces the clip teeth against the aluminum teeth of the channel. The more pressure, the tighter the hold. The recess on the back side of the clip is for a standard screwdriver blade. Inserting and rotating instantly reduces tension on the fabric, or removes the clip from the frame. Here's how to use the SignComp tensioning system. First, determine how many tension clips are needed. You will need no less than 2 tension clips for every perimeter foot or 30 centimeters of frame. For example, a 3-foot or 91 centimeter square sign has a perimeter of 12 feet or 3.64 meters per face. For that sign, you need 24 tension clips per face. Next, trim your sign fabric. For dual frame and other straight tension channel frames, make sure there is at least 1.5 inches or 4 centimeters of extra fabric on all 4 sides of the assembled frame. For tension frame and other angled tension channel frames, additional fabric is required. Allow for 3 inches or 8 centimeters of fabric on all 4 sides of the assembled frame. Next, for all frames, draw a tension clip placement line on the fabric, graphic side up, 1.5 inches or 4 centimeters in from the trimmed edge of the fabric. Better yet, if the assembled frame is available, simply place the frame on the fabric, center the graphics, and trace the outside edge of the frame. When using angled tension channel frames, keep in mind that additional fabric is required. For signs larger than 10 foot by 10 foot, or 3 meters by 3 meters, the clip placement line needs to be adjusted inward to accommodate the stretch factor of the larger fabric. Move the clip line inward 1/4 inch, or 1 centimeter, for every 5 feet, or 1.25 meter increment, over 10 feet, or 3 meters. Keep in mind that each brand of fabric has very different stretch properties. SignComp publishes a fabric requirement and tension clip guide for your use. After the clip line is drawn, notch out the corners of the fabric. Cut away a 2.5 inch or 6 centimeter square from each corner. Now, attach the tension clips. Just inside the clip line, place the mandrel on the fabric with the locking voids facing down. Fold the fabric over the mandrel and stand the mandrel up, lifting the edge nearest you. Orient the clip body so that the SignComp logo faces you. Use thumb pressure to snap one end of the clip body over the mandrel and fabric, and palm pressure to push the rest of the clip body down onto the mandrel and fabric. It takes just a few seconds per tension clip. The locking voids on the underside of the mandrel keep the tension clip firmly attached to the fabric and prevent migration of the clip once the sign face is installed. Tension clips should be attached no more than 3 inches or 8 centimeters apart. No need to measure. Just use the clip body, which is approximately 3 inches or 8 centimeters long, as a guide. The tension frame and other angled tension channel frames require slightly tighter spacing. You can move a clip along the fabric without removing it. Just slide the clip. Put a finger under the edge of the fabric and slide the mandrel, then the clip body, and so on. The clip can be detached from the fabric if needed, but only by pulling the fabric straight out of the clip. There is absolutely no possibility of the fabric being pulled out while the clip is within the tension channel of the frame. After the clips are attached around the perimeter, you can insert the fabric into the frame. With your fingers, just push the tension clips with the fabric into the tension channel of the assembled sign frame. The Delrin plastic tension clips easily slide inside the tension channel. This side-to-side maneuverability is a great advantage in positioning graphics and removing wrinkles. Because the clips are not screwed to the frame, continuous tension is achieved across the frame, reducing the possibility of scalloping. For upright signs, start at the top. Gravity will assist you as you tension down each side of the assembled frame. Once the fabric is loosely in place, you can begin full tensioning. Hook the small button on the end of the tension tool over the outside rail on the frame. Rocking the tension tool, press one of the wings of the tool against any part of the clip. You will hear a click click as the tension clip moves down into the tension channel. The clip is designed to hold at equal strength no matter what angle or depth it is pushed into the channel. Continue by sliding the tension tool along the frame and pressing downward on each clip. Slide press, slide press, working your way around the frame. Do not over-tension the fabric. You simply want it flat and smooth, not tight as a drum head. If you apply too much tension, simply release the tension with a screwdriver and reapply the correct tension. If you have any excess fabric, it can be easily trimmed off without the risk of damaging the sign face. With the SignComp tensioning system, untrimmed excess fabric does not protrude from the underside of the frame, so it will not cause unsightly shadows if the sign is illuminated. When you have the tension just the way you want it, you can quickly install the frame cover and you're finished. The SignComp tensioning system is fast, accurate, easy to use, and extremely strong. And because it reduces installation time, it will make you more cost competitive job after job. The SignComp tensioning system, the most advanced flexible sign fabric tensioning system on the market.